And then Hedwig came with a letter. It said, "Dear Harry, do you want to come to the burrow? Hermione's there." So one day he went to the Then Fred and George came in. But they were weird. And Ron came. They've been weird for a little bit. Then Hermione came. "Hello, Harry." They played Quidditch all afternoon. "I'm almost to the goal, trying to get me. I'm gonna get you with a bludger. I'm gonna get the golden snitch. I'm gonna get the quaffle. I don't know what I'm gonna do." Then once they were tired, they came inside and ate dinner. They ate till their tummies were all full. Then they went to bed. But that night, Harry had an unpleasant dream. He had a dream of him somewhere that he doesn't know. But there was no trees. Then, right in front of his face, popped up you know who. Then Harry and him had to fight the whole day. When he woke up, he was happy because you know who was not. Then they played Quidditch all afternoon. "I'm gonna get the snitch. I'm gonna get the quaffle. I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna hit a bludger. I'm gonna get in the goal." They play the whole time. Then they ate breakfast. They ate. And finally, when their tummies were all full, they had to walk to the Hogwarts Express. The Hogwarts Express was now filled with kids. They were late, so everyone got in. Faced from each other. Then it started to move. They talked and talked all about Quidditch until they got to Hogwarts when it stopped. Harry, Hermione, and Ron went in one of the carriages. And then the other two, Fred and George, went in another. Well, it wasn't nice for them. They had to be added with Malfoy, who talked to them about how he is better than them. Then when they got there, they got the Great Hall. They sat down at one table, all talking and talking and talking and talking. And Malfoy, well, Goyle was sick, so Crabbe just sat down with him. Then we saw Snape at the staff table. We saw Dumbledore, Hagrid, and this one guy with this ginormous eye. "Is that Mad-Eye?" screamed Ron. "I don't know," said Harry. Then Professor McGonagall came. And then they started talking. Dumbledore started to talk. "Now we have
the Triwizard Tournament. Everyone screamed, but some of them were like, what? Then Dumbledore said, if you said what, this is what the Triwizard Tournament is. It is when wizards go through tests and see if they are a true wizard. Now, we shall fill the table with food. Then, Dobby, probably in the kitchen, looked out. All the other elves popped and made food come on all over the table. Now they were ready to eat. They ate and ate and ate. Then they went to their common rooms. Grabbed a mouthful and went there. Hedwig went with Harry. To Gryffindor common room. And Ron. And Hermione. And Fred. And George. They all went. Then they had a big conversation. And then Harry interrupted. He didn't tell us what you have to do to enter it. Wait, what is that noise?
Ding, ding, ding.
Oh no, they forgot something in the Great Hall. So they all scrambled back. And, but Crabbe and Goyle were already there. They beat us. They all said. Then Dumbledore said, to enter,
yes, right.
They said, you must write your name on a piece of paper and put it in the Goblet of Fire. So then they all went back to their goblets. Crabbe and Goyle went to their common room, and all of the other Gryffindors went to Gryffindor. All the Hufflepuffs went to Hufflepuff. Now the Gryffindor common room filled with noise. That noise was not familiar. It sounded like bump. But Hermione has just went to the bathroom. And it was coming from the bathroom. It was a troll. Oh no, they all screamed. They raced, Harry and Ron. They raced and raced and raced. Finally, they found her screaming because the troll was trying to kill her. So then Harry stuck his wand in the troll's nose, and then it fell to the ground. Ew! Troll blocker. And then, what happened was the teachers came. Jedi Moody came back. And then Snape. And then Professor McGonagall, then Dumbledore, then Hagrid. They all came in and said, what the? Then they sent them back to their company. It was scary what just happened. But they had to do it. It was their friend that was. So they all talked about it. Then they went to the next day. They went to breakfast. It was crowded with noise.
But in all the speeches Harry heard, he always heard the word that they defeated last night. Troll. They sat down, then scrambling, Malfoy and Crabbe came and said to Dumbledore,
"There's a tiny spider in our common room. It makes no sense." "Oh, we wanted to trick him." The others laughed. Then Malfoy was so mean, he left to the library. Then Ron said, "He's probably going to get a book called Why Is Harry So Mean?" Then Crabbe to probably find the same story. Then Gryffindor was the only one. Gryffindor, Hufflepuff, and Ravenclaw were the only ones there. Gryffindor all talked, talk. And then Dumbledore said, "I do not know why Malfoy and Crabbe are gone. It's probably because they're going to find a book about why is Dumbledore talking right now." Then they ate. Then it was time for Harry to have Quidditch. Everyone else was there, watching in the stands. They were all there. They were all up in the stands. Then the Quaffle was up. The Snitch was up. The Two Pleasures was up. But Harry didn't notice. He was right under one. He flipped out of it right when it was an inch from him. Then Harry and Malfoy went for the Golden Snitch. They had to get it. Then they were looking backwards to find it, and they slipped, and they hit each other. And down they went. But then they came back up. And then, hello, they were trying to kick each other off. Harry kicked Malfoy. Then it was just Harry the Seeker. He flew around, trying to find the Snitch. Then he found it, but it was in one of the Gryffindor's hands. He came in, said, "I'm going to try." Then he gave it to him. Gryffindor wins! "Yay," all the Gryffindors said. Harry flew around as happy as could be. When he got to the ground, he tried to stop himself, but he couldn't. And then he Well, then Fred just climbed up. I mean, Malfoy. Then one climbed down. Ah! He was falling. Harry swooped. You. Good luck. They all went back to their common room. "That was awesome," said Harry. Said Hermione, Ron, George, and Fred. When they kicked Malfoy off, it was amazing. Everyone laughed. Malfoy
It was the last day. They were all getting back to the train. They had to go.
It was another year at Hogwarts. Now they had to go. They all sat by each other. Then
the other two sat.
They started, then
they went.
When the train was back to platform 9 3/4, they all got off and walked away. Mr. Dursley was there. How was that weird school?
It was good, said Harry. Then he just fell over and fainted. The end.
All right, you gotta do a casting call one at a time. You gotta show us who they are and what their names are.
Harry.
Bring them up here.
Harry. Ron. Fred. George.
Get them closer together.
Hermione. Hedwig. You know who? Hagrid. Mad-Eye Moody. Dumbledore. Snape. Professor McGonagall, Freeman, Dobby, the stubbiest one, Crab, and Malfoy. Now all of them are bowing, and the crowd is like this.